Responding to the question regarding the UN's intervention to stop wars, including the attack by Israel on the Palestinians in Gaza, the president of the UN General Assembly, Dennis Francis, explained that, as the UN, they swiftly moved in to stop this war before it had even worsened, but unfortunately, all their suggestions were abused by some of the member states. He added that, as we speak, over 25,000 innocent people have lost their lives in this war, yet by the time they had intervened, the death toll was still low. He further made it clear that the UN is not responsible for all this mess. It's the states which decide on whether to push for peace or violence.
War and peace are decisions that countries make for reasons best known to themselves. It is not the decision that the UN expounds and promotes, for the very reasons we are seeing in Gaza. Because it's painful, it's dastardly, it's dehumanizing, it's destructive. Think for 1 minute of what it would cost.
Dennis Francis added that it's unfortunate that some states have continued to violate their commitments in the UN Charter, to the extent that during wars, they attack UN offices, yet they're supposed to be a safe place.
Bombs were being dropped on UN facilities, contrary to the provisions and dictates of international law, contrary to the principles of international humanitarian law. Those are supposed to be safe spaces, as indeed are places like hospitals, health centers, schools.
In order to save future generations, he suggested that countries should always front peace and negotiations, because during the wars, no one wins apart from people losing lives. One of the questions of including African countries on the UN Security Council, he gave confidence that the reforms are underway.
If conflicts are not contained, they have a way of multiplying and spreading. And so our hope is that those countries in conflict in Africa will find the courage and the strength to come to the table and to discuss and resolve their differences. The UN is fully prepared to support that process, to bring the parties together, to facilitate that dialogue.
On a lighter note, he commended Uganda for always giving a warm welcome to the refugees, tasking other countries to emulate such acts.
Compliment and commend the government and people of Uganda for their very humanistic approach to refugees. Uganda accepts the refugees, helps and supports them, and prepares them to go on to a country that will accept them.
He noted that for the days he has been in Uganda, he has been able to visit and tour several parts in Kampala, including Makerere University, and is impressed with the way Uganda is conducting its businesses.
It was a truly eye-opening experience and a privilege I do not take for granted to have had the chance to witness firsthand the work being spearheaded in Uganda by the various entities under the United Nations umbrella. I am very proud of that work.
Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.